Was a new song from our new record, and it was called The Eleventh Earl of Mar. But we're going to, the next one we're going to do is one that I'm sure you've all seen this before, maybe. Have you seen this before? Ah, no, you haven't. Yes, this one you'll all know. Sing along if you want. It's called Carpet Crawler.
Yeah.
Was a shady character. He was a thief, a general lowlife, not unlike most of our road crew. And in fact, tonight was going to be the zenith of his career so far, because tonight he was going to rob the very first, the very original Wimpy Hamburger Restaurant of their entire weekly takings. And so he slipped between the guards and he made straight for the room with the safe, and he started to open the safe, and all of a sudden the door opened, the light went on, and in walked the night watchman. Oh, Christ, thought Harry. So he got out his gun and he shot him. Well, the man fell dead, of course, but then Harry had the problem of what to do with the body. So he quickly dug a hole and he crammed the body inside, but unfortunately rigor mortis was setting in. So he got out his saw and he started sawing off the man's arms and then his legs. And he pushed the lot in, but unfortunately, the sound of incessant sawing set off the automatic alarm system. And within moments, the building was surrounded by police. Ooh, poor old Harry was arrested. This is his story. It's called Robbery, Assault, and Battery.
Deserted, the police were alerted, they considered the phone call a hoax. Furtively glancing, they guiltily prancing, the youth could be guards and away. Slipping between them, he hoped to have seen them, the eyes of the own, the sun near. But all shining bright, he stole on in the night, till he came to the room of the sun.
Yeah. attach me to a chain that'll attach me to that DRI that I'll find why. And if they try to hold me for trial, when I stay out of jail, I'll pay you my bail. And after I'll go to the court of appeal saying,
thank you. This next song is a sea shanty. It tells of Myrtle the mermaid, who lived at the top of a very tall lighthouse. And all the sailors fancied Myrtle. And in order to gain entrance into her boudoir, they had to perform a ritual dance at the front door of the lighthouse. Now, we have a sailor tonight, brought specially along to demonstrate the mating dance of Myrtle.
Space, space.
And he sings too. This song is off the new album. It's called Your Own Special Way.
Wherever you are, followed quite lonely.
she's going at all.
Play you a new song. A new one, what you won't have heard unless you were here last night. Anybody here last night? Good, I'm glad you're in the minority. This song is all about a poor unfortunate man that goes to a party, meets a lady with very large knockers. And it depends who you know, really. And unfortunately, she seduces him. And then she claims that he raped her. It's all very eternal triangle. It's off our Spot the Pigeon EP, which is currently racing up the Indonesian charts. And it's called Inside and Out.
Says it will be fine. just as blind as he can tell a lie. It's the same old story, but it says you're not to worry, 'cause some you lose and some you lose. At the party he was on his own, all he did was say he'd take her home, but it seems they didn't go straight there. On the porch she told him, "Keep your hand here." It's the same old story, and they told her mom she's not to worry. What she says is so. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Now, the other morning, we were sitting down at breakfast and we had our papers out when all of a sudden, on the door. So I opened the door and there was the mailman, and in his hands was a very big box. So I took the box off him and I put it down on the floor, and on the cover it said, "Highly inflammable, do not bend, beware, watch out." And so, of course, I opened the box, and there, lying right on the bottom, in amongst his drum kit, curled up, fast asleep, was on the drums, Chester Thompson. I would like to say that we will only accept credit cards or used dollar bills for Chester. See me afterwards. We're going to carry on now for all the benefit of those listening for a few tracks from our new record, beginning with In That Quiet Earth.
Thank you. dust that circles all around me. I must find a new home. Ways and homes that used to give me shelter, they're all as one to me now. Oh, but I would search everywhere just to hear your call. Walk upon stranger roads in this one, in a world I used to know before. I miss you more. Oh, oh, oh. Than the sun reflecting off my pillow, bringing the warmth of new life. I caught a glimpse of in the night. Now I've lost everything I gave to you, my soul. The meaning of all I believed before escapes me. In this world of none, nothing, no one. And I would search everywhere just to hear. Walk upon strange roads in this one.
Three thousand pounds of custody working, right? Thank you.
Thank you. Happy New Year again. A bit late. It's nice to be back at the Rainbow. I remember about 5 years ago here, we did our first... I'm going to say it again, too. And the day before. Our first visual presentation here with a Foxtrot album. And I remember everything was chaos backstage, and we got ready 5 minutes before we went on. Well, this is the third night, and 5 years later, it still happens. This next song is off the Wind and Wuthering album again. It's a piano-based song. Good heavens, he's ready. And it's called One for the Vine.
Thank you.
red hands from an open mouth. Now you look both ends, but a little dead in the middle.
You're not
Thank you. I think we enjoyed that one too. What can you say? What can you say? The next song is another bit of Genesis melodrama. This time, it's a much maligned creature that gets the brunt of our humor. It is, of course, the mouse. Now, this particular mouse has a very sad story to tell. It's the story of his struggle to coexist in a world filled with two-legged and four-legged creatures, each bent on his extermination. Oh, indeed. Well, the lover is played by Mr. Anthony Banks. And we have, making a marked difference from his usual role as a sperm whale, Mr. Michael Rutherford as the mouse. A brief cameo performance by King Kong, Mr. Chester Thompson. And of course, every story has an evil person, and this one is the cat played by Mr. Stephen Hackett. Boo. This is called All in a Mouse's Night.
to the wall. Then comes this monster mouse, he's 10 feet tall, with teeth and claws to match. It only took one blow.
And now the dulcet tones of Mr. Stephen Hackett.
Hello. Gonna do a slightly older number now. From sunny England. Thank you. This one's a little old song about a river, and it's called Firth or Fifth.
The path is clear, though no eyes can see. The course lead down long river. So with gods and men, the sheep remain inside their pen. Though many times they've seen the way to lead. He rides majestic, past herds of men. He cannot or gaze with joy. Oh, you see reflected there the trees, the sky, the leaf air. The scene out there is lying just below. Off the town from view, like a cancer growth is removed by skill. Let it be with the eye and the waterfall. He is mad and gone, and in the sea. He sings for me. Na-na, na-na, na-na. Na-na, na-na. And I know songs urge thy sailors on to look by the siren's cry. the river dissolves in the sea. So Neptune has claimed another soul. Oh, and so with gods and men, the sheep remain inside their pen until the shepherd leads his flock away. The sands of time were eroded by the river of constant change.
Now I want to tell you a story. Now this particular story is all about Romeo and Juliet. Ah yes, friends in the audience. Well, Romeo, tonight, it being Friday, was feeling very, very horny. And so he decided to telephone his young lady, Juliet, who was 16 years old, and just as horny, to ask her out for a drive with him in his car. Well, of course, Juliet had no alternative but to accept the invitation, and within the hour, they were in the back of his car, at it. Well, Romeo was a bit of a slow starter, and the first half an hour went past without saying a word, but slowly and very seductively, he removed some of her clothing. And then he ate her pants. Anyway, when she was completely naked, Romeo very excitedly undid his shirt and took his trousers off. He had to do this himself because Juliet was tied to the steering wheel. And anyway, I didn't know so many people tied their girlfriends to steering wheels. Anyway, Romeo was about to approach Juliet like that. Or was it like that? No, it was definitely like that. But luckily for Juliet, from her crouched position by the steering wheel, she noticed the clock on the dashboard. Romeo, untie me, I must go home. Now wait for it. Romeo was very excited, you see, because he hadn't had it for weeks. And he said, Juliet, you can't leave me like this. She said, I must, I'm very hungry, and supper's ready. Walking across the city.
It's good to feel you again. such a long, long time, isn't it?
We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Thank you. You stand there with your fixed expression.